Maybe I'd be happy to let it all go and dedicate my life to making jelly molds. Learn to cook and learn to sew. I'm a happy homemaker. Hi, and welcome to the Comfy Red Couch. My name is Tracy, and I'm your host, and I'm coming to you from a rainy day in Toronto, where yesterday it was beautiful and sunny, and today the rain is coming down so that the spring flowers can come up. At least that's what I'm telling myself. This is a podcast about knitting. This week I have a little bit of knitting to share with you. I have one wonderful brown package to share with you as well. And I think it's going to be a shorter episode. I do have some footage from yesterday. We had a wonderful day in Toronto, and I'm going to talk about that a little bit on Bits and Bobs, and then I will share some of the footage as well, because it was just such a lovely day, and I think you'll enjoy coming to where we went to. So, especially if you're not from the Toronto area. So, if you would like to find me, I am Tracy RR on Ravelry, and I am at Comfy Red Couch on Instagram. If you are new to the podcast, welcome. This, as I said, is a podcast primarily focused on knitting, although every once in a while there will be some sewing things or some other crafting things, but usually it's knitting. And if you are a returning viewer, you know I love having you here, and welcome back. I know that you have your beverage of choice and you are snuggled up wherever it is that you like to sit and watch, and you are working on your project of choice, whether it is coloring mandalas or knitting, crocheting, rug hooking, whatever it is, I know that you are out there and just ready to see what has been happening in my bags. I do have a finished object to share with you this week, and I also have a work in progress, but I really didn't get a lot of knitting done, as much as I would have liked, but there are weeks that that happens. But for now, it is tea time. It is time to drink some nice warm tea for me, because it's still a bit chilly out there. And today I have a very special mug, and I'm actually jumping a little bit into brown paper packages here. I got the most amazing package on Friday at the end of the day, and the timing could not have been more perfect. So I will share most of the rest of the contents with you on brown paper packages, but for this lovely mug that says Follow Your Dreams and is super sparkly. It's got little gold speckles on it as well as pink speckles, so who wouldn't love that, was in this package. And there was also some Bird and Blend tea in the package, so I am drinking fruit salad. I'm just remembering the bag with fruit salad is in the kitchen, so I'll have to, when I make a break between segments, I'll run back and get it so I can share that during brown paper packages. But this is fruit salad. It is a lovely pink. It is an herbal tea. It smells delicious. I have made a little stump teapot of it so that I can enjoy a little bit more than just a cup. So here is to spring and wonderful friends and lots of lovely crafting time. Cheers. Oh my goodness, this is going to be so delicious as a cold brew. It's delicious as a hot brew, so I know it's going to be amazing as a cold brew, and I cannot wait to get my cold brewer out. But for now, let's move on to the knitting. As I'm podcasting, I sometimes wonder if you can see the wheels in my head turning. So when I realize that the tea is over there and I'm here, and how am I going to get that so I can share that with you? I wonder if you can see the inner workings of my mind. Sometimes things that come out of my mouth and the way that my mind works they don't always quite jive, so I call things buttons when they're obviously not buttons. The fun of podcasting. Anyway, I did jump up and grabbed the tea. It is in the parcel that I'm going to share with you a little bit later, but for now, it is time for my favorite things. And I have two favorite things to share with you this week. And I'm going to start off with a little bit of magic. And this is the Asphodel Cowl. And this is a test knit for the lovely Tracy of Nora George Yarns. And I'm definitely not as far as I would like to be, but I'm farther ahead than last week. And I am using Nora George Yarns, and this is the Wand Chooses the Wizard. This is one of the Mrs. Weasley's Sock Club kits, and this is the Wand Chooses the Wizard. And it came with two minis, this gorgeous caramel, which is now disconnected because I don't need it till the very end, and this lovely blue as well, which is also disconnected, and it is just a magical blue, just like all of Tracy's yarns. So the Asphodel Cowl is a beautiful cowl that Tracy has designed, and there are several test knitters. I have now fallen way behind. A few of them are already done, but I needed to work on some other things this week, and I had some other things going on, so I'm not as far as I would like to be. So it has this beautiful ribbed section, and then it has a slip stitch section. There's this lovely pattern here, some quatrefoil, and that's where I was last week, was in the quatrefoil, and these eyelets, I had made a mistake, so I went back and changed it up, and then I have this lovely mosaic pattern here, and then I am now into the zigzag. I want to be careful I don't take any stitches off my needles. So I'm into the zigzag now, and I think I've got to tink back a row. I think I've got something wrong there, so I'm going to go back one more row. And then I am hoping to work on this a lot this evening. And it is just, oh, the bee's knees. I just love it. It's going to be such a beautiful, beautiful cowl. And the colors that are, how they are knitting up, just spectacular. Anyway, Tracy is going to be releasing this pattern, I think nearer to the end of April, although you never know, it might come up a little bit earlier. And I just hope to be finished by then so I can have all my notes to her and have a blocked photo ready to go. So here's this lovely little zigzag pattern here starting, and just there's the inside of the mosaic garter section. It's been a fun knit. And when I pick it up, I have a really hard time putting it down. And that makes it difficult because sometimes I'm just not in a place where I can knit a full round, and then I get distracted. And when I get distracted, I make mistakes because I am human. Yes, I am. I do make mistakes, and I have to often tink back to get them. Anyway, this is a beautiful, beautiful pattern, and I like how it sort of goes with my shirt today. And I cannot wait to share more with you. I'm really hoping that by the next time I podcast, this will be off the needles, blocked, and ready to share with you. It is living in my lovely Bird Leg Bags Spells bag, because this is a purely magical cowl. One of the interesting things, and I never knew this until I started looking up what asphodel was, so A-S-P-H-O-D-E-L, I hope I pronounced it right. One of the first things that Snape says to Harry Potter in the first book is, what do you get, or what happens when you mix asphodel and wormwood? And asphodel translates to a lily. And so you've got lily, and then you can look up wormwood. And it's a really interesting, so if you look up the quote about asphodel and wormwood from Snape, it's a really interesting Harry Potter thing that comes out where you never would have thought, just one of those little clever things. So there is magic living in this bag for sure, and I cannot wait to get to the magic today after I finish editing the podcast. I am just itching to pick up that project again because it's been a few days. The next thing I'm going to share with you, I almost forgot to put the counter back in with that project. That would not be fun. The next thing I am going to share with you was living in my bird legs bag, cherry bag, and this is just one of the lovely little boxes. I got this actually from the Sock, Simply Sock Company, and they had some bird leg bags, and this one's great because it just folds up flat when you don't have much or anything in it, but then it boxes out when you do. And inside are some lovely polka dots and two little remaining balls of yarn, and that's because I am now finished the Samphire socks. And Samphire socks were the socks that Helen Stewart, Curious Handmade, just released this past week, the second pattern from the Sock Society. And I had one completely done for release date, and then I had one partially done, and I took a photograph, and I think it was great actually how I did take the photograph of it flat on the needles, because the pattern on the front is a little bit difficult to see when you're trying to photograph flat. So the fact that it was on the needles, I actually really liked that photograph. So it didn't hurt that I wasn't completely done, because at least I had one done and my notes were in. So the Samphire socks have this lovely pattern on the front, and then they have, I think it's Broken Rib is what the name of this is, on the back. And it's interesting because I bought a Julie Asselin yarn a little over a year ago, and I really want to do a sock at some point with that yarn, which is this pattern, this Broken Rib pattern. There was a sample at the Purple Pearl, and I just loved how it looked. So I do have some Julie Asselin yarn ready to make into a full pair of socks like this, but it was nice to get the practice. And this one has been blocked. And this one I finished early this morning. So I haven't blocked this one yet, but it will go into, have a little soak and then be put on the blocker later on. So I'll go with this one that has been blocked. So a twisted cuff heel, and then you've got the Samphire sock lace pattern at the front and Samphire sock Broken Rib at the back. There is a slipped stitch heel, and I like how the texture really changes there, and a lovely little heel turn, and then a wedge toe. Now, one thing I do with Helen socks, I have sort of a wide foot, so I usually stop my toe if I'm doing a wedge toe a little bit earlier than it says in the pattern, because I don't like it too pointy. I like it a little bit more flat at the end, and I usually stop when I've got 28 stitches on the needle, so 14 and 14, and then I do a fold over so that I don't get those little wings, although I've got a little bit happening there. And let's see if this one's as bad. A little bit on one side there. But I go down and I flip it over. I take two stitches at the very beginning, knit them together, and then, or Kitchener stitch them together at the beginning, the two first ones, and then I also Kitchener stitch the last two ones together at the very end. So that was a little trick that I learned in one of my sock workshops. So I usually stop my toe a little bit earlier than in the pattern, but otherwise I have followed the pattern. This is the medium size, and I used Cozy, Zelana Cozy yarn, and it is just so fluffy and squishy. These are going to be definitely nice and warm for the fall. Although I do have to say, on Wednesday of this week, hello Tasha, on Wednesday of this week, it was so cold at work. I was wearing my mittens and I had several sweaters on. If I had had a hat with me, I would have worn it. It was so, so cold in my office at work. And I was wishing, as I was knitting on these, that I could be wearing them. I was wearing wool socks, but I was freezing. But these will be perfect for the fall, for sure. So the Samphire socks, the pattern is now out. And the next pattern will be coming out in, it is April now, so June. That'll be pattern 3, and every 2 months the Sock Society comes out. So I have a finished object, although I do need to block the second sock. And that's all I've got for my favorite things. I don't know if you saw Tasha came and she's now sitting beside me on the couch. I'll see if I can angle the... There she is. Nice to have a little one beside me. And I can now pop these in here for the moment and continue on. I'm going to be going on to the brown paper packages segment in a second. This week, I was expecting my mailman to drop off at least one package for me, and he did. The thing is, it was not the package that I was expecting to see. I was expecting the Mrs. Weasley's Sock Yarn Club for March from Nora George Yarns. And I'm still expecting that. I'm sure it will come at some point next week. But instead, I came home on Friday and I had had a very challenging afternoon on Friday. And it had been a bit of a rough afternoon. And I came home and there was a parcel on my porch behind a little stool that we have there that we keep gardening tools in. And I looked down and I thought, oh, what is this? And I picked it up and it was a big parcel. And when I saw who it was from, I had a really good laugh, and they will understand why in the coming days. But on the top of the box, when I opened the parcel, was this gorgeous robin that was hand-colored, and it has a lovely message about spring in there, because I'm always complaining about winter. I know this. And inside were just so many lovely treats. So I did share that this was in here, Follow Your Dreams. I will try. And there was Bird and Blend fruit salad. This is what I'm drinking today, and it is absolutely delicious. And oh, smells heavenly. So inside, lovely little fruit pieces. I'm going to need to pop the glasses on so I can read all the ingredients so that I'm not telling you it's one thing when it's really not. So on go the glasses. So fruit salad chews, the glorious childhood penny sweet. There are apple pieces, hibiscus, rose hip, freeze-dried raspberry, elderberries, pineapple pieces, yum, lemongrass, orange flowers, orange peel, papaya cubes, strawberry pieces, and then flavor. It may contain traces of nuts, so if you are allergic to nuts, this might be one that you need to avoid, but delicious, delicious, delicious. And oh, this is going to be absolutely and completely amazing as a cold brew, because it's really good as a hot brew. And I always find the fruity teas are the best for cold brews, and I'm really looking forward to getting my lovely cold brew filter out. So that was one of the things in the parcel. The Next thing I saw had me speechless for I don't know how long. And it was just, it's so beautiful. And I did put a photograph on Instagram. So Christine, who is the person who provided the bag, she made the bag for our, the royal wedding. We had the royal wedding knit along last year, and Christine made the bag. Her daughter Sam dyed a skein of yarn, and they provided the prize for that knit along that we did last May. And we're coming up on the first anniversary soon of that royal wedding. In a little bit, I know it was May 19th, but Christine made the bag. Sam embroidered this amazing little laundry scene, which is just adorable. And look at that amazing fabric that they've used. And just like my other bag, so when I went to Disney, I took my Alice in Wonderland bag. Christine made, she needs to make bags. But just love this. Got that in the way. Detachable wristband. I usually keep them on, but it's great if I have a bag that maybe doesn't have one. I can always pop it on one too. And so it's on that D-ring. And inside, I'm going to try and fold it so you can see inside without seeing the contents at this point. There is some fabric, and then there's a pocket made with this material here. So it's so well made, and oh, just so, such a lovely surprise to come home to after a horrid afternoon. There's no other way to put it. So in this little care package, it was from Manchester, because they are from Manchester, a lovely little bee pin. And this one's nice because it has the rainbow on it as well. And I think this pin needs to go here. So I'm going to do that now while I'm thinking about it. And now every time that I show you my empty basket, there are now three pins on there. So that was one of the things that was in the bag. And then there were some lovely treats for me. I love Cadbury's. There's lots of crinkling going on. So I got these lovely Whisper bits. And I don't know why. We do have Cadbury in Canada, but British Cadbury is so, so much better. I don't know why. And my favorites. Cadbury Easter cream eggs. I love these things. So that was in there as well. And there was a lovely glycerin soap. And my sister-in-law was over yesterday and she was smelling it and just thought it smelled absolutely lovely. I wish you could smell it. It's so pretty smelling. And then there was this gorgeous skein of yarn, and this is from the Peak District Yarns, and just look at those amazing colors, that blue and the pink and the purple, just look at that. Oh, blue is my favorite color, but I do tend to gravitate when I'm knitting towards pinks and purples, so I think this is just a perfect skein. And you can see the inside of the bag now with the pocket. Nice big pocket. And I cannot tell you, the timing of this was perfect. And as I said, they're going to get a really good laugh this week. So anyway, this is what I have to share on brown paper packages this week. And it was definitely more than enough. And I now have a new pin and an empty basket. I will say that I am hoping that my Nora George yarn arrives this week, and I know that I will be getting a very special package tomorrow because UPS tells me I will be getting that tomorrow. And normally I would save it until my next podcast, but I'm actually going to be starting to knit with the yarn that's arriving tomorrow. And I will talk a little bit about that project. I think you're going to be very surprised when you hear what I am knitting again. And I'm excited to share a little bit about that project once I've started. But if you want to see the yarn that arrives, I will take a photograph and I will put it on Instagram before I wind it all up, because it's going to be very, very pretty for sure. Anyway, look at that bee. It was a very, very nice brown paper package this week. It's now time for Bits and Bobs, and this is my segment where I talk about anything and everything not necessarily knitting related. And there was a lot that happened this week. On Monday, we went down as a family to do our interview for our Nexus cards. So we all had the day off, and about midday we drove down to Niagara Falls area. We met my lovely sister-in-law for lunch, and we just went to Swiss Chalet. And if you've ever been to Canada, or if you live in Canada, Swiss Chalet is a rotisserie chicken place, and it's just, most people love Swiss Chalet. So that's where we went for lunch, and we had a really, just a nice, quiet, relaxing lunchtime with my sister-in-law and a lovely afternoon. And then we drove and had our interviews and then came back, and it was a really nice sunny afternoon. It was sort of mix of, it was very windy, a bit chilly, mix of sun and cloud, but a nice day. And then Tuesday I took a workshop. And a little over a month ago, I was talking about how I wanted to take a course in restorative practice, and I finally was able to take part one of the workshop. So restorative practice is not quite mediation, but similar, where you're trying to get two parties to agree, or a group of people to be able to restore the peace, get things back to where they were. So I was able to take the part one session, and I did that with a couple of my coworkers, and it was a really great day. Just a different way to spend with my coworkers, learn a little bit more about them as well, and just a really productive day where I was also able to get a qualification, or start earning a qualification that I'd been wanting to. So that was a nice way to spend my Tuesday. And Wednesday, Thursday, I was back to work. It was really, really cold at work. As I said, I had mittens on. I was chilly, chilly, chilly. And Friday was a great day until the end of the afternoon. And yeah, it was a bit frustrating. But Saturday was the best day. Saturday, we went so my sister-in-law, my brother-in-law, and their three children all came to Toronto, and they're on their Easter break. They live just on the other side of the border, so they have their school break now, and so they decided that they were going to come and spend a couple of days in Toronto. So they've taken a hotel, and we decided that we were going to spend Saturday together and just do some activities. Unfortunately, Isaac was not able to join us for the day part because he's in rehearsals and he had a full day Saturday rehearsal at school for Rent. But the four kids and the four adults, we had a really, really good time. And I'm going to put some videos in. I'll insert them as we go along rather than putting them as a whole segment at the end. But it was just a lovely day. So we did the best of Toronto. What we did was we went to the CN Tower, and That's at least how we started our day. We didn't end our day at the CN Tower. It got better. And one of the things that I'm going to tell you, if you ever come to Toronto and you want to go to the CN Tower, I'm going to tell you how to do it. There is only one way to do this. And that is to go to 360 Restaurant for a prefix lunch. And yes, it is pricey, but going up the tower is pricey on its own. So if you were planning on going and making a day of it, you were probably going to grab lunch somewhere anyway. I always recommend do the lunch, the prefix at the CN Tower. Lunch, not dinner, because lunch A is always a little bit cheaper, but also you get to see the daylight. Well, oftentimes dinner, it's dark and all you see are lights, and I don't know, I guess it's pretty, but you can see across the lake and see all the little things during the daytime. So we had a beautiful, sunshiny, clear day for our observation time, and we went up the tower. You don't have to stand in the lineups for, there's little lineups as you go, but it's just a lot nicer to go the 360 way. And you go up to the restaurant. When you get to the restaurant, they seat you. We had a wonderful table. And the restaurant is a revolving restaurant. So you start looking at the east end of Toronto and you just do the revolution all the way around. I think it takes an hour to do the full revolution. And I've never been there for less than that. So you definitely get at least 1.25 or 1.5 of the view of the city. And it's just a relaxing way to really enjoy the view. And then afterwards, you get to go downstairs to the observation deck and you get to walk across the glass floor. And it's crazy, crazy down there. It's just, I don't think I could last more than a half an hour. So to do the lunch and then go down afterwards is definitely what I would recommend. So we went up the tower. We then had an amazing lunch. And my sister-in-law and I went, all the boys went to the washroom and took Violet with them. My sister-in-law and I had a little chat, and I'll put that right here.
We are in the CN Tower. This is my lovely sister-in-law, Julie, and I often talk about my lovely sister-in-law. And hi, she's joining us. We are hi above the city, just enjoying a really lovely lunch. We had Caesar salad so far
with amazing bacon.
Yeah, and the main is going to be coming out soon. Nathaniel is over there eating pasta, and everyone else has gone to the bathroom. So we are just having a fun, lovely family time.
Indeed. Yeah. Very much so.
And then everybody came back, and we had our mains and a lovely, lovely lunch. The view was spectacular.
I am at the top of Toronto and we have just had lunch at 360 at the CN Tower. It is a wonderful restaurant and we just get to watch the city go by as we rotate. You can see that we're going this way. We're just over the lake right now and there is the Toronto Island. The airport is just down there too, but it's always such a wonderful time to come up here, and this is really, I think, one of the best kept secrets in Toronto.
And afterwards, we went down to the observation deck. I did walk across the glass floor. It is a terrifying thing to do.
Walking across. I am way, way, the wall. Problem is, now I have to get back. My house is just over there. Do you see it?
They tell you how many, I think they can put 3.5 orcas on the glass floor before it will break. I don't think they've ever tried it, but apparently they can do it. And, but it's a little bit scary looking, you know, walking across and looking down. And after we left the CN Tower, we went to the aquarium, which is at the base of the CN Tower.
All right, guys, welcome back with Elevated. How is it, Wilson?
Good. Thank you.
Great.
So we are facing towards southeast end of Toronto. Looks like Financial District, right side right in the area, and Toronto Islands. If you like, you can look down below your feet to glass panels to track the progress we got all the way down. No. Heading down with the same time and speed as you came up, 22 kilometers, 50 miles an hour, yeah. Takes over 15 seconds to reach comfort.
Oh, yeah, my ears are popping.
I was way up there. And now we're on our way to the aquarium.
And I had never been to the aquarium. Everyone else in my family had been, I believe. But I had never been, and it was really lovely. There were lots of really amazing parts. I liked, they had a conveyor belt, so one of the sidewalks, a moving sidewalk, not a conveyor belt. Conveyor belt put vegetables on. But they had a moving sidewalk, and you just stood there, and it just took you, and it played music while you were watching the animals around you, and there were sharks that would go over your head, and stingrays. It was just amazing to do that.
We got Johnny, ready?
There's the turtle right there. There goes the turtle. Are you gonna go swimming now, Nathaniel?
We can't go swimming here.
Why not? There's a shark right above your head.
Oh my.
Oh my. Lions and tigers and sharks. Oh my. Oh my gosh, there's another one. Oh, and a third.
And a fourth.
Oh my.
And a fifth and a sixth.
Oh my indeed.
Got to weigh the kids and see how much they would be worth if we were to sell them as tuna. And I've got another little snippet with my lovely sister-in-law, what we were going to do if we sold our children. I know it's not going to happen, but it was fun to talk about.
Get a picture of the weight scale. I did get a picture of the weight scale. So our kids, when we put them on the weight scale, it would have amounted to about 5,500 something to sell them.
$17.95 every pound.
Yes. So I think it would have been really great if, as you suggested, we put both of our husbands on there and sold them all off and went on like a really fabulous vacation. It'd be so fun. Would you have worked pictures?
I really want to be married too, so.
Oh, transatlantic.
Something fun.
Go visit all your friends in England.
Yes. Better yet, all the way around the world.
Daniel!
Daniel, what are you doing right now?
As you can see in here, if you can see, I'm petting
you. You're petting the stingray. Mm-hmm. What do they feel like?
Really,
do they feel slimy?
Yeah, slimy.
After the aquarium, we came back to the house and we all had hamburgers and just the boys played upstairs. Isaac was home, so he got to join in. Isaac played some music for us and it was just a very busy day. But it was really nice to spend it with my lovely family, and it's always fun when Julie and Steve and their children come over. Just a lovely time. So that was my Saturday, and that was a really nice way to end off what had been a very varied and full of activity week. So I think that's all I have to share on Bits and Bobs. We are coming up on the Easter weekend, so it's a 4-day week ahead, work week. And I think for next week, I will podcast, but I'm not sure which day I'm going to podcast. So we've got a 4-day weekend. I may leave it till the Monday. I may stay on schedule, I may put something up early, but I do want a podcast. It'll be a little bit different. So at some point on that long weekend, you will see what I've been up to. And I'm really hoping to have this one finished. Anyway, I think that's all I've got for bits and bobs. And it, like in my brown paper packages segment, was enough. Thank you so much for joining me on the Comfy Red Couch this week. I hope that you've had a chance to sit down, relax, that you have been able to get a lot of work done on whatever it is you're working on while I have chattered away about what I've been working on. I am wishing you a wonderful week ahead. I know that Easter is a very busy time, but I'm hoping that you can take some time for yourself and spend it doing something for self-care or with the people that you love. And I am wishing you just all the best in the upcoming week. I would like to say a special thank you and a special happy Easter to Christine, Sam, and Nikki. You really, really made my week. You can see a little Tasha ear popping up there. Your timing was impeccable, and you know that because I was having a little chat with you all. So anyway, I am wishing everyone a wonderful week ahead, and I look forward to seeing you next week on the Comfy Red Couch. Bye. My editing afternoon consists of lots and lots of chocolate. I have no idea how I was able to not eat this between when it arrived and today. I had to share it on the podcast, so I had to try and keep it, you know, from out of my belly. Probably keeping so busy yesterday helped the distraction, you know, so that I didn't eat this, but this is not going to last long at all.